Halo bassinet is $250, brand new. We purchased this, well, 6 months ago when Michael was just about to be born for $125 off of Facebook Marketplace?
I know, I can't remember which one.
Anyway, Craigslist, Facebook Marketplace, one of those. And now, Michael has outgrown it, and so it's time to move this Halo bassinet on to the next baby for $120, which means we spent $5 over the last 5 months of Michael's life for him to have a great bed in our room, but now he's in the crib, in his own room. So, minimalism and memories is the title of today's vlog, but minimalism, question of the day, is minimalism even on your radar? Like, living minimally, which we're not, you know, perfectionists at minimalism, but we do strive to sell things, move things on if we're not using them. And that comes up quite often, like this Halo bassinet. So, the lady's coming over right now to buy it. We're excited. 120 bucks in our pocket, cash, money. Pulling out the parakeet. Let's go. When the drone comes out in the neighborhood, everyone comes out of the woodworks, man. The Mormons, the neighbors, the boys on their bikes. Oh, my. Map of Kukasaki, famous National Geographic magazine. Basically my favorite runner, Haile Gebrselassie, when he broke the 204 marathon. Photo albums, Yankees, running. Minimalism versus memories. We all have memories. Sometimes they're memories stored on a, you know, in a photo. Sometimes it's memories in a VHS tape. Sometimes it's memories in a computer hard drive. You know, we store memories in different ways. Well, this is my trunk. This is my trunk. I opened it for you. I've been meaning to open this for a long time, actually, but time moves on and it gets buried away in the house somewhere. Well, I pulled it out of the house, Michael's room, and basically, I love history, I love stories, I love storytelling, and this chest is a collection of items that I have kept over the years. I have not thrown away. I have not minimalized or reduced my trunk of stuff. And it is a lot of stuff, mostly photos from the last 30 years of life. A lot of photo albums, and even I've, you know, inherited a lot of Bridget's old photos into this trunk now that we are one family. And gosh, it's hard. For example, this is my original running log from 1999. Like, this was an old, I don't even know, it was a notebook that I put electric tape around. I taped a USA Track and Field sticker, a Foot Locker sticker, and then a Pikes Peak Roadrunner sticker from 1999. Now, I had started running a couple years before that, but like, this was the beginning of starting to take my running serious because I was writing down my workouts. The first one, June 8th, 1999. It was the Turquoise Lake Half Marathon in Leadville, Colorado. It was a rough race. I ran it in 2 hours and 4 minutes, 13 miles at 10,000 feet. I think I almost died. I remember that race being very hard. The next day, actually on my birthday, June 10th, 1999, I ran 20 minutes, 2.5 miles on a treadmill, I guess. I don't know where that was. Anyway, it's interesting to collect memories, hold on to them, and I like to clear out, we like to clear out our stuff. And so all I'm saying, folks, is we have to discern and think long term. In 30 years, in 50 years, will the things in this trunk be of value and of, frankly, I would just say like entertainment value down the road? And I would say yes. I just looked through some of the photos, and listen, we may not open this trunk for another 10 years. I don't know. But there were some objects and some photos and some memories in here that are irreplaceable. And it will be. Maybe not now, but it will be fun way down the road to open this up and look through it and just see what we find and just kind of have a good laugh and a good, you know, walk down memory lane. And so all I'm saying is minimalism versus memories, memories versus minimalism. You know, we all have to discern in our own way how we're going to store our memories. And maybe it's right up here and that's it. And you know, you don't have photo albums, and that's just fine. For me, I like the trunk for now. You know, it's like, I like it. I like having it and pulling it out, you know, once every 10 years. And, you know, we'll see when we pull it out again to reflect back on life and on the blessings that we all have. And we all have our own little blessings in different ways. And that's the question of the day, of course. How do you remember your memories? What do you do? What do you, maybe it's a song, maybe it's a VHS tape, maybe it's a walk around a park, and that's like your walk down, literally your walk down memory lane. I don't know. Love you guys. It was fun to open this trunk with you. That said, seek beauty, work hard, love each other. Thanks for stopping by. See you.